Good morning, everyone. My name is Anvish, working as assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College in civil department. So now the topic which I am going to tell you is about engineering geology. Okay, so this is a branch which gives you the knowledge on the geological conditions. That means the physical structure. So physical structure of earth or as ground. Okay, so it is a branch which deals with the study of physical structure of the earth. So in physical structure of the earth, so earth consists of what? So earth consists of many islands, right? Like continents, earth. Okay, so earth consists of land, right? This is land and water, right? So earth consists of land and water. So land, how lands are formed, right? So the formation of the lands, the formation of the islands, the formation of the earth or the rock strata. Okay, so this may be a ground level. So this is the ground and you are having different layers of stratas. Okay, so how these stratas are formed, how, what is the types of the stratas? Okay, so those things you can learn, and also the type of the rocks. Okay, so if the ground is consists of rocks, so ground consists of rocks like soils, right? So different types of rocks, different types of soils we are having in land, right? That means on earth. So these, a study of rock, mostly the geology deals with the study of rocks, that is the petrology. Okay, so petrology is a branch which gives you the knowledge on rocks. Means it gives you the formations. Okay, so it gives you the formation, it gives you the composition, right? It gives you the formations, that means the origin. So from where it originated, so those things you'll get, you'll get the composition and you'll get the structure and texture of the rocks. Okay, so this petrology subject or engineering, you can call it as a petrological engineering or you can call it as petrology. So petrology deals with the study of the rocks. Okay, so here geology, engineering geology consists of a number of branches. Okay, so in which we are having the petrology, that means the study of the rock. So how the rocks are formed? Okay, so rocks, so we are having different types of rocks. In that major classifications we are having igneous rocks. Okay, so igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Okay, so these are the three main basic classifications of the rocks, the main major classifications. Okay, so why we are reading this, or why, what is the need for a civil engineer to study the why? Okay, so as a civil engineers, we think that we don't need to study about the rocks, we don't need to study about the soils, right? So, but the thing is that you should remember that every load that is transferred from the structures that you are constructing will transfer to the subsurface. Okay, that means the surface, subsurface or the subsoil. Okay, so that means which is beneath the ground, right? Okay, so all those loads, they have to be transferred to the subsoil. So that subsoil consists of It may be consist of rocks, it may be consist of soils, right? Excuse me. So we must and should learn, or we should have the knowledge of engineering geology, that means the study of the rocks or the study of the soils. You should know the properties, you should know their structure, you should know the structure of the geology, okay? That means structure of the earth or the ground strata. Okay, so that can help you in analyzing how the or what type of loads it can take, how much amount of loads it can take, right? So these are the three major rock classifications, okay, igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. So how these rocks are formed, let's study. Okay, so first one is igneous rocks. Igneous rocks, okay. So the how these igneous rocks are formed, basically the earth's surface of the lands or the islands, they are mostly formed because of the eruption of volcanics, right? So volcanic eruptions, right? So you will have volcanic eruptions, okay. So it may be a volcanic eruptions, or it may be because of the lava that is present, okay. So there is a presence of lava in the ground, okay. So this lava, it will come, right, as an eruption, okay, because of the increase in the pressures in this lava state, okay. So here this lava will travel and it will come out of the surface from the outcrops. So whatever the mountains, okay, so whatever the strata that is above the ground level, we call it as outcrop. Okay, so this lava will come and will deposit at certain locations, and there is a formation of rocks, right? But one more thing is that these igneous rocks, so the rocks which are formed from the lava, we call it as igneous rocks. Okay, so lava can be formed, or the igneous rocks can be formed at the surface, or else this can also form inside the ground. Okay. So wherever the gaps in between the stratas, okay, so wherever the weaker sections are there, weaker joints and layers are there, there this lava will penetrate and form an igneous rocks. Okay, we call it as intrusive igneous rocks. Okay, so we call it as intrusive igneous rocks. Whatever the igneous rocks that is formed outside the ground level, okay, so above the ground level or outside the earth surface, this we call it as extrusive igneous rocks. Okay, so that's how the rocks are formed. That means the igneous rocks are formed, that is formed directly from the magma. Okay. So that is formed directly from the lava or magma. Okay, so the rocks are formed, igneous rocks that are naturally formed, they are formed. Now because of the weathering actions, okay, because of weathering actions by the wind, okay, it may be by the water, like natural agents, okay. So the wind or air, you can call it as the air, okay, water, ice, or else glaciers, okay. So because of these natural agents, weathering actions are happening on the igneous rocks, okay. So the sedimentary rocks are formed, okay, sedimentary rocks. So this is how the sedimentary rocks are formed. Sedimentary rocks are formed because of the weathering action of, okay. So because of the weathering action, whatever the rock surface, okay. So this rock surface, it will be eroded. Okay. So erosion will occur because of the weathering. So the whatever the surface of the rock, it will become weak. Okay. So the bond between the inner body and the outer part will become weak, and it will separated by the natural agents. Okay, so they will be get separated by the natural agents, and those sediments. Okay, so we can call them as sediments. Okay, so these sediments, they will get transported. Okay, transported, and then they get deposited, right? And because of the compaction and consolidation, these sedimentary rocks are formed, right? So because of these compaction and consolidations, these whatever the sediments that are collected from the parent rock, that is the igneous rocks, it may be a metamorphic rocks, they will collect, they are get separated because of the natural agents, they get transported and they get deposited at a certain place, and because of the compaction and consolidation, they form as a single rock, all the sediments. Okay, so all the sediments, they will form as single rock, that is the sedimentary rock. Okay, so these sedimentary rocks, because of pressures, okay, so because of pressures, because of temperatures, okay, so because of more pressures and because of variations in temperatures, what is happening is the sedimentary rocks, or it may be a igneous rocks, so there will be a change in the properties. Okay, there may be a change in the physical properties, there may be a change in the chemical properties. Okay, so the properties will be changed, and the structure and textures also will be changed. Okay, so that change causes the formation of metamorphic rocks. Okay, so that's how the metamorphic rocks are formed, because of the pressures and the temperature variations on the sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rock, igneous rocks and sedimentary rocks. Okay, so you can also draw like, so this is all from the igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks are formed, and also from the sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rocks are formed because of temperature and pressures. Okay, so these metamorphic rocks, after the changes in the ground, because of the temperatures, because of the pressures, what will happen is, after many many long years, they will be converted as lava. Okay, so they will be converted as lava or magma. Okay, so this magma again will form as igneous rocks. So that means even the igneous rocks are formed because from the metamorphic rocks, because they turn into lava, and this lava will form the igneous rocks. Okay, and as we are saying, that sedimentary rocks are also formed because of the weathering actions of igneous rocks, okay, that we have drawn, and also because of the metamorphic rocks. Okay, so because of the metamorphic rocks also, these sedimentary rocks are formed, right? So this is a cycle, right? So sedimentary rocks are formed, they can be formed from the igneous both and metamorphic rocks, they are formed, and metamorphic rocks are formed from the sedimentary rocks, changes in the sedimentary rocks and changes in the igneous rocks, right? And igneous rocks, they can also be formed from the lava that is produced because of the metamorphic rocks, change in the metamorphic rocks. Okay, so this is the rock cycle. Okay, so that means this is the formation cycle of the rocks, igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Okay, so that is for petrology. Okay, so this is the formations, that means the origin, right? So formations, origin and structure, different structures and different textures of these rocks, these different types of rocks will help you in selecting a good materials. Okay, that means they can be materials like granites, Okay, so these rocks you can be used as rocks, and you can use those rocks for the construction purpose. Like granites, you can, those granites are nothing but metamorphic rocks. Okay, so those rocks you can use it for the construction purpose, and the rocks which can be used as a foundation rocks. Okay, since they are good at taking the huge amount of loads, that means the igneous rocks. Okay, so those igneous rocks, they are good at taking the heavy loads, so they are used as a foundation materials. Okay, and also different types of rocks, different type of sedimentary rocks, different type of metamorphic rocks, igneous rocks, we are using them according to their properties. Accordingly, their properties, we are going to select them for different purposes of civil engineering constructions. Okay, thank you.